All right, the Albanese government has looked over a local defence company for a major contract in favour of a French-owned one. Labor has announced that Tales Australia will run the operations behind a new plant to produce artillery shells instead of the Queensland-based Noya. Daniel, does this make sense to you, this decision?
Well, look, I think so long as the process was rigorous, so long as it was against the selection criteria, and I think what we find with most of these projects is that there's a local component and they're often partnered with an international company. And I think that the company that you'd referred to, which was locally based, did have an international partner which they worked with. So look, I think so long as there's a rigorous process and selection criteria are used, I think it stacks up.
What do you think, Keith?
Well, somehow the government, the Labor government, has to defend this decision. So they've awarded it to a contractor for a factory that doesn't exist, that will take 4 years to build, against an Australian company which already has a facility based in regional Queensland at Maribyrnong, just outside of my electorate, and they're ready to go. They could be up and running in 18 months. So it's 4 years, greenfield, no current approvals.
So you know this company well because it's close to your electorate.
I know them very well. They're in Lou O'Brien's electorate of Wide Bay. They received significant funding from the Commonwealth to be able to set this facility up at Maribyrnong. And, you know, let's be clear, at a state level, this was a Labor seat up until the weekend. They're well known, they're a good company, they're international level, and yet somehow an existing facility is overlooked for one that has to be built. So I think there are real questions to answer here, Sharri.
Okay, let's have a look at university, pardon me, university fees. We know that Australia's top universities rely too heavily on international students, and now they're set to hike the tuition fees by 7%. In 2025 for international students. This comes as the Albanese government is looking at introducing or preparing to introduce a cap on international student numbers. Daniel, do you think this fee increase is a direct result of the reforms that are capping the number of international students?
Well, just taking a step back, I would think that both sides of politics at the moment would say that we need to reduce overall numbers of international students. So we might differ on the exact numbers or on the exact methodology, but I think everybody's agreed that we need to reduce the numbers of international students. I was at a conference last week where I was engaging with a lot of stakeholders on this issue. It's a very complex issue because you want to pare back the numbers, but in a way where you're sensitive to different institutional needs, considering the G8, considering regional universities and so forth. Yeah. Look, I think that part of this might be a reflection of that, in the sense that if you have a certain amount of demand and you reduce the number of spots, one of the factors that might change is the price. I mean, this is economics, but I think everybody's agreed that we do need to reduce the overall numbers. For me, it's just a question of doing it in a way which is staged sensibly and takes account of all the different institutions and needs.
All right. Daniel Mulino, Keith Pitt, thank you both very much for your time, and good to see you here in person in Sydney tonight, Keith.